Wow, what an amazing day in Southern California after all the rains. Oh, it's absolutely beautiful. A little bit chilly, it's a little bit wet, so I'm gonna try and stick to a little bit more paved route. You know, about, it's been more than 500 miles ago now, I put my leg over a Turner Bikes Cyclosys Titanium gravel bike. Today I'm gonna be talking about that bike, how it's been to ride through all the things I've put it through, what I've changed, what I've tweaked to make it mine, so to speak, a little bit. And we'll be talking about, who is this David Turner guy and why does he think we should buy one of his bicycles? I mean, the noiva of the guy. Come on, let's go for a ride. Chance to throw a leg over it and ride one, I immediately liked it. And after a couple months of riding, I realized I didn't want to give it back, so I bought it. All right, let's find a spot out of this Arctic wind and let's take a look at the components on the bike, the way I've been riding it, and a little bit of what I have changed and why. Now, to begin with, I wrote it the way that David Turner sent it to me, the way it was built up. Some of the things I have not changed. The main components are a SRAM Mullet setup with a with Force road shifters and a 12-speed 1052 mountain bike cassette, Eagle cassette, on the back with an Eagle GX derailleur. And I did a video a while ago on learning to love the Mullet, how that's been for me. And if you want to know more about how I feel about the Mullet, you can look that up. I'll put that link in the description. But suffice to say, it's been very good. Yes, there are some downsides. I talk about that in the video. But generally speaking, I'm in. I think it's worked out really well. It's given me the low gear that I was looking for. And basically, I do have a gear for just about every occasion. And it's been reliable and it's gotten me up some really, really steep, nasty places. I appreciate that. Good enough on the road for this old guy, at least for now. And yep, the Mullet is here to stay. The wheels are Easton EC90AX. It's a gravel wheel. I believe it's about 24 millimeters internal. Hookless, I believe. If I'm wrong, I'll put that up on the description. It's a fairly shallow rim profile. I think it's low 20s or so as far as the depth of the rim, which I think is good. They have a reputation, from what I can read, of being a decent riding carbon rim. And so far, those have been quite good. I've had Easton wheels before with their hubs, their vault hubs. And yeah, I've had some miles on them and I've got no complaints. And that's what's on this bike. Now, I did change tires. You know, I'm a fan of a lot of the Wilderness Trail Bikes tires, and a couple of them in particular. And I've been running the Resolute in a 42 millimeter size. And on these wheels, they plump out to just about 44 millimeters. And I'm running those tubeless, of course, with the Wilderness Trail Bike sealant in there. And run them usually between 30 and 35 pounds. Like today, I could put a little more because it's kind of a paved road. But when things get a little rougher, just put a little bit of air out of there. And those tires are really a little big if you do a lot of just fast dirt and smooth dirt and road. But for where I live, it's a bomber tire. I really enjoy riding the WTB Resolute. I tossed a couple titanium water bottle cages on there. I have three. My glab's stuck. I have three of them. And those are made by Silka. It's a Silka, their Thai, I think they call it their Securo cage. And I've never lost a bottle out of them. They've been great. I only got two of them on there for today, but the third one mounts on the bottom of this frame because Mr. Turner decided three water bottle brazons was a good idea, and I agree. I always have some kind of a bag on my bike, like a frame bag. I really like having a half frame bag on a gravel bike. I find that so useful that I leave it on pretty much 100% of the time. Right now I'm running this Apadura bag. There's some things I really, really like about it. Their buying process was good. Their little templates is very cool. It looks good. It seems to be made really well, but there's things about it I just do not like. Well, I'm going to get into that when I talk about the bag itself. So one of these days I'll do that. In the meantime, gotta have a frame bag on a gravel bike. That makes me happy. Now, every gravel bike I've ever owned has had a redshift shock stop suspension stem on it. And I won't ride a gravel bike without it, at least not around here. It just lessens that smackdown that you get on all the rain ruts we have here in the rough roads. It's just so nice for a little bit of weight. It is absolutely worth it, and they are gold. And just recently, if you saw my latest video before this one, I started playing around with their shock stop seat post, and it makes me wonder what in the world I was waiting for. You can check that video out too, kind of introducing it. I am doing a comparison between their pro version and their standard version. Today I've got the standard version on there, but at some point I'll be swapping back to the pro, going back and forth, and I'll be telling you guys why I think which one is for you and why. I also changed the handlebars. That came with an Easton, I think it was an AX70. It's an alloy bar, kind of a road-shaped bar with some flare to it. I really had really good luck with a lot of different Ritchie handlebars. So I wanted to try something unique. And here's the thing. The more that your gravel bike is not like a road bike in the way you ride it and treat it, there's no reason to think that your handlebar should just be a slightly tweaked road handlebar. So I looked at the Venture Max. Now the Venture Max is kind of a unique handlebar. It's probably polarizing and some people might hate it. This is really my first ride on it, but so far I'm totally, totally stoked. Anyway, all right, I'm gonna keep riding a little bit. We'll find another little spot out of the wind, and then we'll talk about what I like about this bike and who this David Turner guy is. See that mountain there with all the clouds on it? You can't see the top of it. I got a ride in mind that starts from my house quite a ways down the road, a lot of climbing to get here. Continues on this road, goes over that mountain, down the other side, then back home. It's like 70 plus miles and over 9,000 feet of climbing. I'm a little bit afraid. One of these days, I'm gonna pedal out and give it a try. So who is this David Turner guy? Why should you be compelled to buy one of his bicycles? You know, I'm not gonna go into a whole bio now, as frankly, I don't have the time to tell all the things that Mr. Turner has done in regards to bicycling and bike building, bike designing, bike racing. So Google him. You'll find out. But you know, there are people in this sport that have shaped it throughout the years. Back to the fathers of mountain biking, you've heard Gary Fisher, names like that, and Tom Ritchie, of course, still doing amazing stuff with bikes and components and whatnot. But you got to put a David Turner in there too, because if you were in the world of downhill and even cross-country mountain bike racing for a lot of years, Turner was a name that you could count on to be on the podium. And while now he's turned his attention more toward, you know, the hardtail world of titanium bikes like the Cyclosys, the Arty, and the other bikes he makes. And he's a creative guy. I'm sure you're gonna be seeing more and different bikes coming from him as years go by, because he's a passionate guy. But passion isn't necessarily enough to create a good bicycle. But when you can blend passion with years and years of experience building bikes, seeing how they work, what makes them good, what doesn't make them good, being able to take all that experience and all that knowledge and craft that into something that you can go ride now, well, I think that's a compelling reason to give a Turner bike a very, very good look-see if you're gonna go ride a check for a new bicycle. Ah, it's nice here out of the wind. Whew, man, it looks like a beautiful day, and it is. It's a bluebird sky, but man, that wind is coming off the snow up in the mountains north of us, straight into my face, and wow, it's chilly. But you know, I'm a wimpy Southern Californian, so you know, doesn't take much to make me cold. All right, I got a goal to get to the top of a mountain up here. We'll see if I can get there before I turn into an ice cube. All right, well, I had to relocate off the top of the mountain there, or the hill, because it was simply too windy to film. So I'm down here on a nice sunny spot on the hillside, and we'll see if we can make it happen here. The sun just came out. It is just fabulous right now. It's been raining so much that the sunshine has been a little rare. I'm gonna enjoy it while I wrap up my thoughts on the Turner Cyclosys. Well, honestly, I could just say, I love riding this bike. And end it right here, but you probably want a little bit more details than that. But I do love riding this bike. Like I said, I'm somewhere around, I think I'm more like 600 miles or so into it at this point. And you know, just recently I used it for the rock cobbler pebbler version. That was a pretty tough day in the mountains. 60 miles, 6,000 feet of climbing on muddy roads, and a whole lot of pushing our bikes. And you know what? This Cyclosys for me was just everything I wanted it to be. It has just been a great companion too for the kind of riding I do. You know, the way he designed this frame set, I think it fits very, very nicely into your just all around gravel bike with maybe a preference for being in the dirt. Yes, you could use this if your gravel biking is a lot of road riding, maybe more like an all road experience. You know, wouldn't be bad, but this thing really comes into its own. It's like a little dog. Its ears perk up when you point it down the dirt road and you say, let's go that way. The geometry on it is very, very sorta, I think, for all-around riding. You know, he does a thing where he takes the top tube and he extends it out from what would normally be the typical reach in any size. So I'm probably somewhere between 10 and 15 millimeters longer on this bike than I am on my Linsky GR250, even though they are both large size frames. And you know, when I was thinking about replacing the Linsky, there was a couple areas I wanted to improve on if I could, without losing that lovely stability in its actual really very capable on these rough dirt roads I had. So what I was looking to do if I could get it was have a slightly sharper knife in a couple areas. And I mean that by way of saying a little sharper steering response out of it and a little bit more response to hard pedaling efforts. Those are the two places where the Linsky felt, well, very solid, but maybe just slightly a little dull. And I thought, well, you know, if I could sharpen that up a little bit, I'd like that. I kind of like a performance bike. I like to get out of the saddle on those little rises in the trail and, you know, try and beat my buddies to the top. And I like doing a lot of climbing. I thought there are times I'd get off the Linsky onto something else and I'd notice, that is a little better. So when I got on the Cyclosys, there were two things I noticed almost immediately. One was the steering response on it. It was really what I was looking for. It still has a lovely stability. You know, on the rock cobbler, I'll show you in the video, we'd be coming down these hills and we're going, you know, pretty quick because it's pretty steep. And all of a sudden you look and you got about 20 different muddy little ruts to pick from. And you know, pick one and you take your chances. So you get in there and be like, you know, and all slippery and whatnot. And those are places where if the bike's handling isn't sorted, if it's a little too quick, if your weight's in the wrong place on the bike, it doesn't fit you well. Those are those little moments that kind of make your pucker a little bit, you know. Not with the Cyclosys. Never felt out of control, totally calm on that. And the only reason I wasn't going faster is because I wasn't going faster. It wasn't because of the bike. Has a lovely pedaling response too. I've noticed that those out of the saddle efforts are more rewarding. On long climbs, it's very, very competent. It just pedals and goes and goes. So he did a really nice job, I think, not only with the geometry of this, but also choosing the tube set. Another thing that's kind of nice about the Cyclosys, and I think that goes for, I think every Turner frame that I'm aware of, you could correct me, but they are also UDH compliant, the universal derailleur hanger. SRAM, he's adopted that, he's built that into his frames, which means that I could run the SRAM transmission on this bike if I wanted to, and I wouldn't be surprised if someday that is exactly what I do. So that is a little bit of forward thinking from Turner Bikes. So like I said, I've used this for my typical rides where I am mixed surface over many, many miles and many, many thousand feet of climbing, and they're typically rough and typically loose and somewhat unforgiving, and this Cyclosys has just been fabulous on every one of those. I got a lot of things coming up this year I want to do with gravel. I can do some bike packing with this. I think it'd be a great bike packing gravel bike. I've got the gearing for it with this Mullet with the 40-52. I think that'll get me most places, and then, well, I can always walk, can't I, if that doesn't enough. And I'm looking forward to lots and lots of miles and smiles with this Turner Cyclosys. I think if you're shopping for a new gravel bike and you think titanium looks pretty, well, I think you would do well to check out Turner Bikes. Well, that's about it for now. About time to head on home and gather up a little bit of lunch. As always, you guys have a great week and or weekend, and go ride your bikes.